Are you ready for some Procreate fun? Well, let's jump in!
Hello everyone! Welcome to my YouTube series. My name is Brenda Bakker and I'm from the Netherlands. I'm working currently on an alphabet based on the book Brush Lettering for Everybody by the Dutch Carla Kamphuis. And today we're doing the letter Y, as I did here. And I did it in a pastel cocktail style, so I hope you will like it. The canvas I'm currently working on is the chalky paper by Trailhead Design Co. And also the brushes are from the set by Nathan Brown. Also Trailhead Design Co. I can't hardly get it out of my mouth. And it's the pastel set I'm working with. So you can use any chalky lettering you want and create a cloudy-like background or gray and just have some fun and try to create something your own. You don't need specifically these brushes, but they work lovely. You can try it with your own brushes you already have. So I hope you have fun and let's do this together step by step. So I'm going to start off with my messy brush pen, but you can use any brush pen you like or any pencil, which is pressure sensitive, but well, we also don't need it too much, maybe a little bit for the curve. But let me see, I'm going to start off with a white one. So the letter Y, the second last one. So I'm going to make a thicker downstroke like so, and one all the way to the bottom and let it snap so it could perfectly blend in here. And then I'm going to create a serif on top and one at the bottom. And we're going to make a slight curl from here upward till here. And maybe I want that bigger. This one was too much, so let's do it again. Upward, thin, 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 thick. This is one I like. Now let's get it in the middle. Maybe a little bit more for an optical in the middle. Yes, and let's going to erase this one because it was a bit too thick. And I'm going to select this one. Create a new layer on top and let's get rid of all the pixels, but you can still see the selection. And now I'm going to those pastel brushes by Nathan Brown from Trailhead Design Co. Let me see, where do I have them, the pastel brushes, and let's go to the dense color. And this was a color palette provided by Jennifer Nichols, and she recently got 5,000 people following her on Instagram, and so she created the challenge out of it. And I like these colors on this background, so let's color these in with the dense pastel brush by Nathan Brown. And let's have some fun. I want it to be a cocktail-like coloring. I created a cocktail glass out of this recently. So I took a bright yellow, bright red. Then go over to the orange. Let's zoom in a bit. Maybe a little bigger. And I do this to the left side. And now let's merge them a bit as match them. Let's go to the pastel also. And what did I use? I can't remember what I did. Smooth shader? Yes, I guess so. Yes. Let's blend it a little bit like so. I won't talk too much because I'm also looking at what I'm doing myself because they're very new to me, but now you can see me play. I don't want to get any gray of the background in it, so I have to draw towards the outside. See, I can drag a little bit of this in and I don't want that, so let's undo this. That's what I'm trying to avoid here, but it's very small, so it's very difficult for me not to. I'm holding my breath, but I like it like this. So, and well, there were some ice cubes in that gloss I created, and that's something I learned from the Drifter Studios, also on YouTube. So let me go into this layer again, get rid of the selection. So here's the letter I, Y, as you say it. And then go and do a selection, freehand, and just create some random ice cubes. Things like so. And we can change that color from there to use saturation and brightness. Just brighten it up a little, like so. And then going to create a little bit of white. So while selected, I'm going to choose white. And I'm going to choose, I guess, the rough edge. No, it's a little bit too much. I'm on the same layer, yes. Do I want that? No, I'm not going to do this like this. I'm going to a layer above. So it's still selected. But then I can erase everything that's not going into that color again. So if I accidentally go outside of the lines, it doesn't matter because I can erase that easily. And let's blend that in a little bit. I'm just having some fun with some colors. And let me see how it works in the end. Maybe I don't like it at all, but maybe I do. Well, we always have the two finger undo. So let's get in erasing this one. Get rid of the selection and see what it does. I like it, but maybe a little bit softer. So I'm going to lower the opacity of that. Maybe halfway. Yes, I like that. And maybe we could draw a cherry within, just like it's something like a glass. Well, we can choose our own imagination, right? So let's go to the dense color again. I'm getting this red. Am I on a new layer? Yes, I'm on a new layer. It's a little bit too big. I'm already liking this now. Create a lighter touch on there. Smudge it a bit. And create a little bit darker. So the same color, but darker. Always try to do an L shape with the color. So like this is the, what was the original color? This was the original color. I go down to darken it, but also more saturation. Smudge it a bit. And erasing a little part, because it's within this one. And maybe some highlights on top of that also, with white, with a sketcher, new layer. And some rim light, like so. And these are the ones I'm going to smudge with the same sketcher, because it's very tiny. Just to give it a hinge of backdropping, because otherwise it will blend too much against the letter. And now I'm going to choose some green. Just to give it a cherry kind of look. Do I like that? Does cherry look like this? I don't know. Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. Darker green, again, the L shape. Create a shadow like here on this side, and the same color but even lighter. Then again to create a lighter on top. And some shadow within here, or maybe a highlight. I think a highlight would be better. Ultra fine. And a little darker behind that. And that I'm going to smudge again. Very careful. I think we got ourselves. Not the green. Undo. Yes. We've got ourselves a fine and cheerful, bright letter I. Should we do some drops? Like it's a bubbly kind of cocktail? We'll do that again. A layer on top, go to overlay. Choose white. And if you have my done one of my classes for the sketchy doodling, let me see, where is it? You have those fine dots. Let's go back to this letter, select it, and then now you've got the letter selected, and we're going to the overlay layer on top again. and just tip every now and then for some bubbly fun colors. I don't like it here, so I'm going to erase this part because I think it's too hard for color. So, and also this one is too hard, so I guess I like it now. So this will be our letter for today. I hope you had fun. The brushes and the canvas I used are from Trailhead Design Co. by Nathan Brown. And the letter is coming out of the book by Carla Kamphuis, Brush Lettering, Alphabet Series for Everybody. See you in the next one. Thank you for watching this episode until the very end. If you like this video and think I've earned it, please give this video a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't already. More detailed tutorials can be found on Skillshare. These and all other links can be found in the description below. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!